Hey, what's up? I'm Ajit here from Motion Mango. Welcome again to a very exciting and stunning tutorial. Today we are actually gonna be creating this very interesting title animation. We will use a third party plugin, Trapcode Particular. Look at this. I am thrilled. Are you? Let's jump right into the After Effects and create this together step by step. Before we get started, I request you to please subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any updates. Please do check my other tutorials as well. These tutorials include the project files which you can download free of cost. One more request, can I get just 100 likes for this masterpiece? It's free, it will really help me a lot. Okay, without any further ado, let's get the party started. Create a new composition. Select the preset HDTV 1080, change the frame rate to 30 and the duration 10 seconds, hit OK. Create a new solid and go to the effects menu, then noise and grain and hit the fractal noise. Again go to the effects menu, then blur and sharpen and click the fast box blur. Change the blur radius to 10 and change the iteration to 1. Select the layer and pre-compose it. Go to layer menu, then pre-compose. Name it fractal and choose move all attributes and hit OK. Create another solid layer and name it matte. Go to the effects menu, then transition and hit the CC image vibe. Expand the gradient sub option and change the layer source to fractal. Go to very first frame and add a keyframe for completion and change its value to 10. Select the layer and press the U key to open up the keyframes. Go to 3 seconds forward and increase the completion value until the layer wipes out completely. Go to 5 seconds and add another keyframe with the same value. Now go to 7 seconds mark and change the value again down to 10, so that we have something like this. Let's hide the fractal layer first, as we can't see the effect now. To fix it, select the matte layer, go to effects, then generate and hit the fill and change the color to whatever you like. To make the edges sharp and get rid of this blurriness, go to effects menu, then matte. Apply simple choker and increase its value to 2. Now select both the layers and pre-compose, name it transition 1. Now go to the project panel, select the transition 1 composition, duplicate it. Now open the transition 2 and select the matte layer, right click on it, layer styles, and then hit the stroke. Increase the stroke size to 15, set the position to inside, add a keyframe to inside position. And before the ending part, let's change it to outside. Expand the blending option, then advanced blending and change the fill opacity from 100 to 0. Now go to the main comp and import your logo. You can type your own text as well. You can go either way. Drag the logo to the composition. Now pre-compose it. And select move all the attributes. Name it logo main and hit OK. Shift the logo main layer underneath the transition layer and change its track matte to alpha inverted. Now drag the logo main into the composition again from project panel, then drag the transition 2 as well above the logo main layer. This time change the track matte of the logo layer to alpha matte. Now select both of these upper layers, pre-compose, name it emitter and move all attributes. Hit OK. Switch the emitter layer to 3D by clicking this 3D box. If you don't see this switch panel over here, toggle it on and off from this button at the lower left corner. Let's hide the emitter layer. Create a new solid layer and name it particular. Hit OK. Go to the effects and preset panel, find particular and double click it to apply. Change some settings inside the particular effect. Change the emitter type to layer, particle per seconds to 3 lakhs, 3000, 00. Change the velocity to 25. Under the layer emitter, change the layer to emitter and layer sampling to particle birth time. Go to the particle option, change the particle life to 1.2 seconds. Keep the particle type sphere as it is. Change the sphere feather to 0, particle size to 15 and size random to 50%. Expand the size over life option and select the third preset like this. Now go straight to the lighting, expand it and enable the shadow LEDs. Change the softness to 100. Color strength to 50 and shadow light opacity to 10. Let's preview the animation. Beautiful. It looks great. Now select all the layers, pre-compose. Name it logo animation. To create the reflection, let's import our ground layer. I have downloaded it from Pixabay. I will share the download link in the description. Drag it to the composition and pre-compose. Name it floor. Select move all attributes and hit OK. Now go inside the floor comp and adjust its settings like this. Scale it. Apply motion tile. Change output width to 300 and checkmark the mirror edges. Come back to the main comp. Adjust the floor and logo animation layer. Now let's duplicate the logo animation layer. Select the bottom layer. Right click. Go to the transform and select the vertical flip. Align the bottom layer with floor layer, assuming it reflection on floor. Convert both the logo layers to 3D. Now as we see, our reflection layer is not visible anymore. To fix it, create an adjustment layer, name it compound blur and place it in between the both logo layers. Adjust the position of the logo layers if required. Now hide the floor layer. While selecting the compound blur layer, go to the effects, then blur and sharpen and click on the compound blur. Change the blur source layer to floor layer and change the maximum blur to 100. Wow, looks amazing. Yeah. To get rid of these sharp edges, select the compound blur adjustment layer, select the ellipse mask, then double click to apply it, scale the mask and adjust it, and increase the feather. Let's preview the animation. Wow, I love it. Now you can play with just change the main logo layer to any other logo or text and all the animation will update. Okay, that's all for now. I hope you guys like it. If you really like what I am doing, please support me and subscribe to my channel Motion Mango. I will share the project file link in the description. If I will get 100 likes for this tutorial, then you can download it free of cost. I promise you that I will continue delivering the unique and interesting tutorial for you guys. The only thing I need is your support. You can share this tutorial with your friends and hit the like button and please do comment below. Signing off for now. We'll be right back with another exciting tutorial for you guys very soon. Till then, take care.